Hello. Just before coming to the gig, I was having a shower, and my 8-year-old boy, he's laughing for like I don't get a shower. And my 8-year-old boy came in, looked me up and down, and asked when he was going to get boobs. I'm affectionately known as Chippy Tits. I've also got a beard, not because it's like stylish or anything, it's just because when I'm clean shaven, I look like a 13-year-old butch lesbian. I have to shop in Primark now. We got Primark fans in. Anyway, yeah, over the bit. I hate that shop. I have to shop in there now because I used to buy designer clothes and now I'm putting so much weight on so regularly that I can't afford to buy designer clothes anymore. And our Primark here in Liverpool, like when you stand in the main entrance, menswear is only one escalator down and I got like 9 electric shocks. It's like the building itself is telling you that it doesn't want you in there. I always feel as well when you pick any type of garment up your hair, like the faint cries of child slavery. But then you see a pair of jeans for a tenner and you think, fuck them. There's always two types of women in there as well. The first one I like to call Kelly Bogeye. She's got those black see-through leggings on and Ugg boots that go in like that. She looks like she gets out of breath going downstairs. She was with a sister as well, Jackie One Tracky. She's got yellow fingers and stinks of disco minge. I hate Primark, man. I grew up in Anfield. Anyone from Anfield in?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's right, El Father Lar. Anfield was like Mad Max in the late 80s when I grew up there. He was just like burnt out cars, prolific drug use, stray dogs and stray kids everywhere. There was no dads, which is weird, just single mothers. I didn't know my dad growing up, and I had two mates as well who didn't know their dad, so we were like a sad dad gang. We were really emotional and shit at DIY. I had a mate in school who moved into the street as well in the summer holidays, and he had really big sticky out ears. And back then, like, they didn't teach you to like accept yourself for who you were and to love yourself. They'd send you to the nearest hospital and you get them fucking stapled to the side of your head. And one day, he was off school for 2 days, so I went to knock. I was quite curious as to why he'd been off school. And he came out and he didn't have sticky out ears anymore. So I was like, oh, have you had your ears pinned back? And he went, no, I must have slept on them funny. So become quite friendly with us. The reason we let him hang around with us is because he come out one day with a quick save bag full of pogs. We were like, you're in. I don't know the age range in here, but pogs were fucking amazing when I was a kid. You could buy anything with pogs. If you knew a drug dealer who had kids under 13, you could buy heroin with pogs. That's how good they were. So we came to stay. We had a sleepover one night, and about 1 o'clock in the morning, he woke up screaming. And so I ran over and I was like, are you okay, mate? Yeah, your fucking ears haven't popped back out, have they? He said, no. He said, if I tell you something, do you promise not to say anything? So I was like, yeah, okay, what's the matter? He said, when my mum goes to work of a night, my dad touches me. I was like, oh my God, you've got a fucking dad. You lucky bastard. At least you can run away from him now anyway with your fucking aerodynamic ears. I find it hard being a dad though, because I don't feel like I had the teachings, do you know what I mean? Like, I've got 3 children now. Like I said, Jacob, he's 8. I've got Isabella, who's 5, and my youngest, Bobby, he's autistic. He's 3, and he's non-verbal, so he can't actually communicate verbally with any of us. And he's been through a few phases. The first phase of communication was just throwing himself on the floor and screaming in the middle of Tesco's while you're doing your weekly shop. I'm lying, I shop in Aldi. The next stage was that he'd grab your hand and he'd lead you to the thing that he wanted, which was amazing. That was brilliant for us. But over the 6 weeks summer holidays, he kind of stopped doing that and just resorted to licking people. And, like, we don't keep him in a cage or anything. Like, he's free range, do you know what I mean? He's out there. So we had to deal with that, me and my partner. And towards the end of the, I mean, have we got, there's obviously parents in here. Does anyone else fucking dread the summer holidays? Like, can't wait for them to go back to school. So I'm sitting there anyway, I'm like rocking back and forth like an extra in fucking One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. I looked over at my partner, she's bit all her acrylic nails off and pulling her hair out. And I started to get this pain, like, up my left arm. And I thought, I'm having an heart attack. And I was fucking glad. Because of this fact, my girlfriend suggested now that I start to eat more vegetarian meals because of the weight issue and thinking I was having a fucking heart attack. Right? So everything I'm eating now has got like kale and like spinach in it. And I've got like a theory that spinach is quite like anal sex. In the way that if you were forced to have it as a child, you probably won't enjoy it as an adult. Well, listen, I hope you've had a good night. I think you've got like two more acts, so this is going to be brilliant. Thanks very much for having me.